far one of the most common issues that people run into when you use spray paint is you don't use it all at once. So when you store it, the tips get clogged. And I know you've heard tips like, okay, when you're done using your spray paint, spray it upside down. Believe it or not, it still gets clogged, especially if it's been sitting for a really, really long time. Well, there's this amazing trick that I'm really surprised that a lot of people haven't heard of, and it's how I clear out old tips of spray paint bottles super fast, like crazy fast. So let me show you how it's done. There is a pretty good reason you haven't heard of this before, because I'm gonna use acetone. Acetone will chew through almost anything, especially plastic. So the reason you've never heard to use acetone to clear out your paint tips or your spray paint bottle tips is because it'll chew right through the plastic. Well, it will, but it will chew through the paint first. So let me show you how to use acetone to clear out your tips super fast. I know it's tempting, but do not use plastic with acetone. Acetone will chew through plastic way faster than you think it will. What you can do is you get these little glass bottles. These are fantastic. You can get them like at Walmart, and I'll put a link to them if you have a hard time finding them. Put a little bit of acetone in one of these glass bottles, and you can just hold on to this indefinitely because it'll last forever as long as you have a good top and it's in a glass container. So there is a method to the madness here, and there's a reason a lot of people don't show you this way. Here's my spray paint, and as I push the button, absolutely nothing happens. Well, all you do is you take the tip off, take a little glass jar with some acetone, drop it in there, and then shake it up. Now, when I talk about a method to the madness, if you do this too long, it will melt the plastic and then your tip doesn't work anyway. But if you keep it to about 30 seconds or less, it's usually the sweet spot. And the other good thing about acetone is it evaporates really fast. So believe it or not, once you pull it out of there, it's not chewing this up anymore because it evaporates super fast. And then I just put it back on my spray can, and it works. Okay, still skeptical, still think I'm using some tricks or something. Okay, here's the ultimate test. It's one of my favorites, truck bed coating. If you've ever used this stuff, it's fantastic for like ruggedizing things, but man, like after the first time you use it and you don't use it all and you put it away, this is it's just infamous for clogging up, and those tips are wrecked. The other one I'm going to show you real quick is Gorilla Glue. When you use Gorilla Glue, the spray adhesive, same thing. The 3M stuff does the same thing. It always clogs up the tips, and it's like, dude, didn't they think of this? Well, let me show you. It's the ultimate test to show you this trick works on almost anything, and it works really well. So the ultimate test, truck bed lining. This stuff wrecks tips, and you can see this one's pretty gooned up already. Might come out a little bit. Yeah, it's not working at all. But this stuff's super thick, and it's usually a nightmare to work with, especially if it's been stored for a little bit. But same trick. And then for thicker things like truck bed lining and stuff, you probably want to do it, shake it up just a little bit longer than you would with regular spray paint. So regular spray paint, I would probably stop right now. With this stuff, I'll keep going a little bit. And let's see where we're at. One thing is you can do it a couple of times, of course. And what I'll do is I'll wipe off the... All right, let's see where we're at. Alright, I still have a really weird spray pattern. I'll try it one more time. Another thing that can help is once you take it out, if you have either a toothbrush or a scratchy, I love the scratchy. Scratchy's good for so many things. And you just clean up the tip, That'll usually take care of your spray pattern problems too. So let's see where we're at. Yeah, a little bit better. No, it's still clogging up. That just might be the truck bed liner, just not great in spray cans anyway. Remember, you can do this several times, but eventually you're just gonna melt the entire tip. So you gotta kind of find that happy medium. But so this one took 3 tries, but now it's back to where it needs to be. I can tell you though, I could feel the tip starting to deform though, and I could feel the plastic starting to melt, but now it's good to go. And one of the tricks also is try to hook it right back up to the spray can right after you do it. That way it shoots paint through and it clears the acetone out of the inside of the tip, so it won't melt the plastic inside the tip. Okay, single take, so you know I'm not using any tricks here. Pressing down as hard as I can, the spray adhesive, this stuff's a nightmare on tips. Take the tip out and you can look at it. Man, it is wrecked. It's covered in glue, and it's probably got glue up in there too. So I'm gonna take my little tip cleaner, throw my tip in there, and just shake it up. Now, I told you there's a little bit of a method. So for some of these like thicker things that come in spray cans, you usually have to do it a little bit longer. But remember, it's right around that 30-second mark. If you go past that, it melts it and it's not gonna work anymore anyway. But just under 30 seconds for most tips, and it works fantastic. So it works pretty good. Now, one thing is it sprays okay right now. What I would do is I would do this like maybe one more time. But remember, do it in little sections. Don't do it continuously. But you can do it more than once. That's getting better. I can tell it's getting better because it's cleaning off the glue off the front. Yeah, a lot better. So there you have it. Super easy way to clean out your tips. And the best thing I do is I hold on to this and I keep this with my spray paint. That way, anytime I'm doing a spray paint project, when I go and grab a can of spray paint, I've got the tip cleaner right there and I know where it is, and then I can always get a clear tip on any of my old spray paint. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you've got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandedDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.